Hello everyone and welcome to a new type of series I'm starting on this channel. Every week I'll be creating these videos talking about the newest information and news about transportation in the New York metro area. Being that this is the first video, I'd like to hear all of your thoughts in the comment section below on how you feel about this series. Let's get into the video. About a week and a half ago, on November 5th, Biden's $1.75 trillion infrastructure bill was passed, which is a very good thing for public transportation, as the United States works towards getting transit ridership back to pre-pandemic levels for multiple different systems. This is especially good news for transportation in the New York City area, as this money could help get some new projects underway. The tri-states were given nearly $14 billion in federal relief, with the MTA taking away almost $11 billion, New Jersey with about $2.5 billion, and Connecticut with almost a half a billion. This money could help the MTA increase service on various subway lines, start phase 2 of the 2nd Avenue subway, and move forward with Penn Station access. Phase 1 of the 2nd Avenue subway was completed in late 2017, and since then, we've barely gotten any news on phase 2 of the project. I do wonder if the new extension up to 125th Street will include CBTC signaling, and if the Q train will still utilize its older R46 and R68 units. It would be weird to see such old trains in the newest parts of the system. For Penn Station access, the environmental review has already been completed. However, no further advancements have been made since then. With the new money for the MTA, the project can finally get fully underway. Penn Station access will bring Metro North service to riders in the East Bronx, stopping at locations such as Co-op City, Parkchester, and Hunts Point. Hopefully, this new extension will include fares comparable to the subway to make it more attractive for riders. Also, maybe a review can be done for possible stations at Sunnyside and Astoria as well. This extension to the Metro North's network is projected to cost over $1.5 billion. There's also much more that could be done, like the Gateway Project, the extension of the subway system to LaGuardia Airport, and the reactivation of the Rockaway Beach branch. We do know that improvements to transit can get extremely expensive though, especially in the New York City area, so I wouldn't get too excited about this. However, it's nice to see the MTA getting its much needed funding. Something you may or may not have noticed recently is that the MTA has been making improvements to the emergency exit doors in some of their subway stations. While before, the doors were only to be used in an emergency and could only be opened from inside of the actual station, behind the turnstiles, now they can be opened with a Metro card or by tapping a supported card on the OMNY reader. This will greatly help people with limited mobility, like those in wheelchairs. The background video was filmed at the Castle Hill Avenue station on the number 6 line, where it appeared a few days ago. Kinda weird that one of the first stations it was implemented in was a non-ADA compliant station. As ridership continues to climb back to pre-pandemic levels, the MTA is exploring new ways to lure riders back to public transit. One of the ideas they are exploring is called fare capping. As of right now, it seems like this will only be available for riders who use OMNY, which I'd say is reasonable, being that the Metro card will be phased out come 2023. According to MTA Chair Jano Lieber, if you ride a certain number of rides, at some point the algorithm will tell you the best deal for you is to have an unlimited pass, so it will give you the benefit of that. Also, anything we do involves reprogramming all those vending machines in the stations, and working on the software and all of that, and we have not made a final decision exactly on how this will work. This will greatly help those who use public transit to get to and from work, by providing them with an unlimited pass should they reach that threshold within the week or month. I wouldn't expect this to come anytime before 2022, however, it is nice to see the MTA exploring different ways to get people back to riding public transport, and with fare capping, it certainly is a way that will benefit riders in the long run. Thanks to all of you for tuning into this video. Tell me your thoughts on all of this in the comments section below. Also, feel free to drop a like and subscribe. Have a nice day, everyone. Peace.